Oh, hi. Welcome back to Super House of Dead Ninjas. Or, as it's known in the UK, Super House of Dead Heroes. Sorry for the missed update yesterday. Mea culpa. Hopefully, I am back on track for the rest of this week. And I'd like to do a stream at some point this week, too. So, if you're interested in that, make sure you follow me on Twitch, etc. So I unlocked another item just by, I didn't actually read the comic, I was just curious as to how long it was, but by reaching the end of the comic, I unlocked another item. So let's see what that is. Okay, reveals the contents of crates and enemies carrying items. That's cool, it's kind of like the, well, not really, I was going to say it's like the X-ray glasses in The Binding of Isaac, but, potentially might be as useful as those. This is one of the items that will spawn in crates and chests and stuff, so hopefully we'll see that at some point during the game. Let's go ahead and pick my loadout here. I gotta say, I wasn't really a big fan of the nunchucks when I tried them. They were just kind of slow, and I mean, having an attack that completely encircles you is neat, but I'd rather have, like, a quick precise attack like the katana. I haven't tried the whip yet. See, it says hits instantly, but the nunchucks say instant attack. And I didn't really think the nunchucks were that fast. Usable items towards you. Well, I guess I should at least try everything I get. I'll stick with the decapitation shurikens. There doesn't seem to be a reason not to use those. Still just have the standard bombs, and I will stick with wind magic from the bowels. And is there anything else? I did unlock the Pink Panther suit. Let's go on ahead and give that a try since I haven't used that yet. And here we go with attempt number 4, I think this is. I will start in the Abyss of Nature again, because I don't see a reason not to. There is a reason not to. Please let me know in the comments. Alright, so how's this whip look? Oh, that's kind of neat. Nice long range on that. So I think I figured out what the friend kills means. I was sort of confused about that in a previous video. And I was scrubbing through one of the old videos, and I saw that one of the named enemies I killed had the name of one of my friends on Steam. Not sure who that was. That might have just been a normal named enemy, but it was I don't know his real name, but his Steam username was KirbyFTW. That was the only one I. That was the only one I saw. I should have had two friend kills. I didn't notice the second one. Man, those guys are tough. I believe the Kirby FTW looked like one of these Mohawk guys. Alright, so I picked up another letter. Still don't know what those are for. Dang it. I wasn't sure how close I would have to be to that thwomp before, Oh yeah, that's right. I used the whip to pull that thing back. Let's ignore that skull, because that seemed to be something bad last time. Bomb that bird. I'm running pretty low on health, which is a little worrying. Running very low on time here. There we go. So I think running out of time, all that does is it takes away one of your lives, which are those marks up at the top of the screen there. I was kind of referring to them as hit points, because, I mean, they act more like hit points than actual lives. You don't lose any progress when you lose one of those. But running out of time isn't as big a deal as I was making it out to be. Oh my god, that was so close. How did I not die there? I wasn't looking at the timer. Oh, got an achievement, Mad Bomber. Oh. Apparently it's not like Spelunky where you can walk through the spikes as long as you don't land on them. Good to know. Good to know. I like how the whip can sort of attack through two blocks. I think the katana could attack through one block, but it didn't have nearly as much range as the whip. Apparently my down attack is still just the dagger with the whip, because I'm sort of tougher than regular foes. Okay, yeah, I've gotten that. Got that tip before. I like the phrasing, enemies who have earned a name for themselves. It sort of hints at a deeper lore in this game than is being presented. Oh crap. I'm not killing these enemies nearly fast enough because I'm not building up any rage. Someone in the comments did confirm that that was how you build up rage in this game. Crap. But I was trying to go back up so I can get those items I missed, but So after you wall jump, you can double jump after that as well. So you can pull out some pretty tricky jumps if you want to spend the time it takes to nail them. There's a clock up here, so apparently the clock disappeared. That's a little that's kind of a bummer. All right. Disappearing Inca. Okay, I don't think that's one of my Steam friends, so that's probably just a normal named enemy. Oh man, the corpse had spikes? That sucks. The heck is that? Oh, that's one of those guys who was killing me in the game over screen. I didn't realize they actually appear in game. That's weird. I wonder if there's anything special about them. I think I like the whip better than the katana. Just based on my use of it so far. Oh, boss time. Okay, let's take a moment to catch my breath here. I still only have 1 out of 2 magic, which is weird because I don't think I've used any magic yet. So I have a few bombs left. I should probably try bombing the boss more than I have been. And 10 shurikens, which isn't great, but better than nothing, I guess. Okay, it's this guy again. So this is the boss I was having trouble with, and I think I realized what my mistake was. I was just trying to do a double jump over him. Well, I pulled it off once, doing the wall jump and then the double jump after that to get more vertical clearance on the boss, but didn't work that time. Actually, I don't even know if I'll be able to bomb this guy. It's going to be hard to get the timing on that right. Crap. Really disappointing when I actually nail the jump and I miss with the attack. I'm getting better at that jump though. Alright. Phew. Oh, I got the x-ray specs. That's cool. And I got a bunch of money and some health, it looks like. I didn't even use my magic on that guy. Totally forgot. Alright, well, making progress. I got owned by the turtle last time, and this time I eventually took him out. Holy crap, look at all these enemies. Oh, there's my friend Monday. That's cool. I need to go kill her. Nothing personal. Whoa! Why is this guy- Oh! I can see that enemy's item. He has a heart over his head. Or it has a heart over its head, I guess. Crap. No, she gave me some shurikens, so that's better than nothing, I guess. I'll take it. Jeez. Man, do I even... Well, I guess it's too late now. I already released those. Alright, none of these guys have time, do they? No. Okay. Well, I took a hit anyway, so it doesn't matter. Oh, jeez. How was I supposed to see that coming? Whoa, can I use this telescope? I guess not. The up button jumps, by the way. there's nothing you can really activate or anything. They can also be beheaded by my shurikens. Alright, like that. That was pretty cool. Alright, so I think I still have a continued. Aw, man! I didn't realize I had to crouch walk under those spikes. Oops. What the? That dude appeared out of nowhere. I had no time to react. Oh, I guess that was my last continue. Well, at least I beat the turtle. Wonder if I unlocked anything for that. I did unlock some stuff. Wow, I have 5 friend kills now. I've only recognized the 2. I don't know everyone on my friends list, sorry. I just kind of accept whatever, anyone who wants to add me to Steam, you know, I accept. Because why not? Unless they start acting like jerks. Alright, let's go see what I unlocked. No new weapons or upgrades, just some more chest items. Ooh, quite a few of them. Slows a fall if it's more than one floor. Does this game have fall damage? It does, I haven't noticed. Download the soundtrack, okay. Oh, well, that's interesting. I can just download it from the app? I don't know how that works, okay. Well, that's different. Violent violence, okay. Kill 250 enemies to unlock that. Okay, well that's cool. None of this stuff is like super, and there are no game changers in here, but it's some pretty cool stuff. Let's go ahead and do another run. But do I want to stick with the whip or go back to the katana? I think I like the whip. I really like the range it has, and it seems to be just about as fast as the katana, so I'll go with that. It doesn't have a drawback like the nunchucks do. It says it has the shortest reach out of all of the weapons. And the ability to pull items from me is pretty cool as well. Alright, okay. I unlocked the next area. Cool. I am definitely making progress in this game. As unleet as I feel sometimes. Is this what this... Oh, crap. That's rough. Ha! Got you this time, jerk. You! Right. Don't get hit by the spikes. And I missed my goggles. Having those was pretty cool. That frog actually gonna hurt me. Looks like it might be, a decorative creature, but possibly not. Crap. Got fixated on the time. And I got hit anyway, which completely. Okay, the frog can definitely hurt you. Yeah, if you're about to run out of time in this game, it seems more prudent to be careful than to rush after the time. Because if you get hit anyway, then it doesn't matter because the outcome's the same. Okay. Definitely don't want to deal with those piranhas, damn it. Alright. Yeah. Phew! Wasn't quite as amazing that time. Oh, there's Kirby FTW again. See, it's neat that the spikes are labeled like that, because I know that it's an enemy and not spikes. Oh. Well, not that knowledge helped me at all, but theoretically, that would have been useful knowledge. Crap! Yeah, no choice but to deal with the piranhas this time. I don't know why I call them piranhas. They don't look anything like piranhas. I sort of assume that any enemy fish in a video game is a piranha. Because, you know, what other dangerous fish is there? barracuda, I guess. Or, you know, a shark, but it was obviously not a shark. Maybe it was a kind of shark. Like, when you picture a shark in your mind, usually you think of, like, a great white shark. But there are a lot of different kinds of sharks, and not all of them are that impressive looking. Ah! You piece of shit! Oh, Sticky, I think that's one of my Steam friends. Poison Stan. Don't recognize the name. If any of you are watching this and are offended that I don't know your Steam names, I apologize. Crap. Well, here's where having the nunchucks would actually help me, because, oh, well, I can't really get up there anyway, so. Spend too much time worrying about trying to get in that area. Alright. I need to duck when I see those dragon spikes. Because it attacks too quickly for me to really get a hit in on it. Trying to figure out if I can... There we go. Now can I actually make that jump? That's the question. Ah, there we go. Okay, I don't have the Molotov yet, so... That's, something I'll have to remember for later. Okay, crouch run. Also, I should just be holding down anytime I fall. Because why not? I mean, if I do the falling attack, then I might be, might hit an enemy I was otherwise unprepared for. And this is really- Oh, jeez! Those guys pop up right when I'm looking at what comes next. I'm trying to figure out what my course of action would be. Okay. You cannot down attack those sparking ghost things. See, I'm learning. It's definitely roguelike. I'm learning valuable information that will help me survive in the future. Oh, the friend kills must be per run. Okay. Oh hey, I unlocked a weapon. Oh, it's a new kind of shuriken. Crap. See, I... Never mind. The ricochet of litigious possibilities. Apologies if I said that wrong. That's neat. It's like a, Not sure what it's like. I'm trying to think of a video game analogy. Like a reflecting shot from Gauntlet, except that it explodes. Oh well, we will see what this does next time. Tune in tomorrow for more Super House of Dead Ninjas. Bye, everyone.